Greetings, Tubadours! Here we are again. Now, before we get on, as many of my regular viewers will already know, I frequently promise to try and keep my videos to the recommended optimum length of around 7 minutes. Unfortunately, I'm utterly useless at this feat, so seldom produce a video in under 13 minutes. And that's where the concept of 4-Minute Thursdays come in. If I come across something that's ticked me off, hopefully I'll be able to vent my spleen in around 4 minutes. It's gonna be a challenge. So, today I give you this individual, CRROW777. Now, those two R's, they are not an error. He puts them in there for some reason. Weird. Now, he looks like a normal enough person, but don't let that fool you, folks. This man has some very strange ideas about the world. He's one of those who strongly believes that the New World Order Illuminati are a thing, that NASA is a forced lie organisation, and that nobody has actually been into space, let alone to the moon. He believes these, plus a host of other run-of-the-mill to seriously weigh out conspiracies. Now, speaking of the moon, which seems to be CRROW's main focus, that's where this dude's internet fame comes from. You see, in 2012, he filmed the Lunar Wave. Now, the Lunar Wave is a series of distortion lines that were seen to traverse the face of the moon. CRROW and others have since filmed those several times, which has led our friend to firmly believe this is cast iron evidence that the moon we see is actually a hologram. Yes, I did say a hologram. Now, many of his followers, in true sycophantic Crawley Bumlick fashion, are swift to pile on the usual supportive rhetoric in his comment section, which does no more than bolster his enthusiasm, and so he keeps trawling this nonsense out. Unfortunately for CRROW, is that this effect was predicted way back in the 1970s. It's nothing new. It was first observed by professional astronomers in 2009 and has been comprehensively described in several scientific papers since then. Now, if you trawl the murky depths of the internet, conspiracist radio shows and other woo-woo outlets, you will quite often see CRROW pop up from time to time, promoting his various paranoid beliefs, and he's usually introduced in much the same way that the equally deluded compound-dwelling online pap peddler Veritas Bay introduces him here.
He's had a very interesting life, you know, marine, roadie, philosopher, astronomer.
Pardon me?
Astronomer.
I know, astronomer? Considering this man is often touted as an astronomer, it might come as something of a shock to the more even-minded that our friend thinks the moon we see is a hologram. But his gloriously misguided view of the universe doesn't end there. He thinks the Earth also has two suns, and it must be true because he's filmed it.
There's the sun we see with our eyes. I'm still scanning around. I'm going to scan back over and find the other object for the first time. There it is, top of frame. This is the sun we do not see with our eyes.
I know, it's ludicrous, but this man claims to be an experienced astronomer, yet he can't even recognize internal source reflection when he sees it. Pan a telescope from side to side, especially a reflecting telescope, and the source light will end at an angle, so you get a secondary, dimmer image of the primary target. Now, anyone who's ever owned a telescope should recognize this phenomenon. An equally clueless confederate of his, one Chris Van Matre, claims to have verified this second sun, which has only served to make CRROW think he's genuinely onto something.
Here comes another clip by Chris on a new day. There is the sun we do not see with our eyes, with a telephone wire in his field of view. When he scans back over to the regular sun, it's not there. There's the sun.
So, one sun is the sun that we see. The other must be a distinctly different sun, since the second one has telephone wires obscuring the lower part of the sun's disk. But wait, what if we take the primary image, monochrome it, and reduce the contrast? There, ladies and gentlemen, is the telephone wire. Does he really think there are two suns? I confess I have my doubts that he really does believe this. I think it's more likely that he's another one of the money hawks who simply says what he knows his subscribers want to hear. So there you go, lovely tubadours. I think I got that in about 4 minutes, probably a little bit over, knowing me. Anyway, Please subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Thank you for subscribing if you already are. Please do comment, share, like, dislike, and all the other lovely interactive stuff that we like to do. I will be back soon with a more full-length video. Don't know what it'll be about yet, but if you click that bell notification, YouTube will send you an email on my behalf telling you that it's been uploaded. So, until next time, be good to each other, be well, I will catch you soon. Hol vaur.